I was anew working on a circuit to switch off these 24 volt batteries. And the idea that came to my mind was to make a kind of acoustic switch. So in the first stage, an oscillator here, made in this case with a 7411 TTL chip, working on 2.9 kilohertz, could also be another frequency. And in fact, that sound, the sound of the chip, is sent to a one-stage audio amplifier, that's here, and then it is sent into a switch unit that switches a relay, and that relay switches a beeper on, say, 1000 hertz or so. So what first to demonstrate it, what happens, the voltage now on the whole circuit here is, say, 28 volts or 29 volts, so higher than the maximum voltage that 24 volt battery can handle. 28.4 volt is approximately the maximum. And when the voltage gets too low, and we can see that here, the oscillator stops and the beeper is activated. We now go to lower frequency, voltage. And on a certain moment, when the oscillation stops here, and there is no longer a square wave driving the relay unit, the beeper switches on. Let's listen. So now I drive up the voltage again to, say, 28 volts, 29, and it stops again. So in the situation where the battery depletes very, very, very slowly, there must be a moment where the oscillator stops and stops suddenly. There is no in between. It works or it doesn't work. And that's one of the aims of this circuit, and also one of the aims of a switching unit. It must, on an exact moment, switch something on or off. And of course, I can make this whole circuit with an Arduino, with software, etc., etc. That is in fact much easier, but I want to do it in the analog way. So let's see where the beeper starts. That's my that was my voltmeter. That switches off on a certain moment, after 4 minutes or so. So you can see that it suddenly stops. Anyway, the schematic of the circuit is here. And then for a 12 volt version. And I made it in the original way to detect a sound in a room, and when there is a sound heard by the microphone at the input, a very loud sound is generated by a klaxon from an auto, from a car. So that's activated with the help of that relay. And I want to tell, there are here in the whole circuit combined, at first a 2 transistor amplifier connected to a microphone, and then a 1 transistor amplifier, and you can set the amplification here, the level of amplification, then the audio signal is sent into the switch unit. And the capacitor here is very important. I've used here a 0.22 microfarad capacitor, but you can also use an electrolytic. And this worked. This made the circuit hang enough, so it activated the relay in a permanent way. But in the first schematic for 12 volt, you can see here that resistor of 4K7. And that means that in this situation, after a certain moment, the beeper switches off. Anyway, it's an interesting circuit, I think. I built it and it really worked. It worked very good. And you can set the sensitivity also. So even on, say, very low level sounds, the beeper can be activated. This is, by the way, the circuit how I made it here in real. Made for 24 volts. In fact, we see the same circuit. Here is 24 volts. Here we have a voltage divider, so that we have here 12 volt to the first transistor stage. In fact, it's an audio amplifier. And here is the relay unit. Pin connections of the used transistors. And here you see in detail the one stage audio amplifier that drives the relay unit, and here the relay unit. I've used here a 22 ohms resistor. You can also use a fuse or a 10 ohm resistor. That doesn't matter much. And the relay, forgot to tell that, is a 12 volt relay. And it has a resistance of 280 ohms DC resistance. 280 ohms. That's also very important. Of course, you can use the break contact of the relay or the make contact. That's whatever you want. And I can tell it works very properly. Again, the overview, easy to make, it always works, and when you want to use this circuit, for instance, with a microphone, you need another stage, exactly the same as this first stage. So, this part must be duplicated. So, this is the first one transistor amplifier, and you make another stage just like this and couple it in via a 470 nanofarad to this stage. And you can also use a third stage. And that means, of course, that the sensitivity on the input of the acoustic switch raises, say, dramatically. I hope it's clear, and I wish you luck with the circuit. I've made it many times, more than once at least. Here the 12 volt version again. And here the signal that's sent into the relay unit. It hops a little bit around, I don't know why, anyway. But, well, you can hear it. You can hear, perhaps there is a bad earth connection, the reason that it hops around, but it's normally quite very, yes, it's a bad earth connection. Now it's stable again. And, well, when the oscillation stops, the beeper starts to work. Now I drive up the voltage again. And that means that there is a clear switch moment. Always searching for that clear switch moment where the circuit works on 1/100ths of a volt, and that's necessary when you do things with lead acid batteries.